Coming up, I'm going to show you how I did my painting, Woman with Head Jewels.
Hi, I'm Sarah, and I make art.
I made a blog post about this painting, which I'll link below, but this was my first time ever using transparent raw sienna instead of regular raw sienna to paint skin. And because the transparent raw sienna is, well, transparent, it made it very easy to make my mixture for the skin tone into a glaze. I remember being so excited to find transparent raw sienna. I was used to using raw sienna for skin anyway, but because I could glaze with this, it meant I could give the skin more believable texture because of the way the paint allowed me to layer now. I also used zinc white instead of my usual titanium white to aid in the transparency. I also used a bit of gray in her skin. I go into more detail about this in my video about how I paint skin in acrylic. I'll link that in the description. But I want to say right here, using gray in skin doesn't have to be scary if you do it right. In addition to the transparent raw sienna and the zinc white, I also use cameline red deep, permanent green light, and transparent middle yellow to mix this woman's skin. I applied this mixture in a single layer all over her face and neck. And then I pretty much used the same mixture throughout the whole piece and just added white when I needed it to be lighter for highlights and black when I needed it to be darker for shadows. I need to point out, though, it's important when you're adding your black and you're adding your white, you probably will also have to add more of every other color. Especially when you're adding black, I find that if you just add black to your base color, it turns muddy. I like to use filbert brushes when I paint skin. They could be large filbert brushes or small ones, depending on how big of an area I'm filling. That and round brushes, because they give me the smoothest. Just a reminder, filbert brushes are those brushes with the rounded heads. This painting was done, I think, over a year ago, but now when I do the first layer of skin, when I'm just trying to cover the whole face, I'll actually use my largest filbert brush, which is the same brush that I use for backgrounds. Gets everything covered super quick. This is one of the paintings I'm the most proud of to this day. It's all because of how the skin turned out, and that's because of the raw sienna. The transparent raw sienna. That word transparent is important. I glazed green over her scarf, and just like with the skin, I just added zinc white to that, which is a transparent white, and then actually, I was still using Mars Black to glaze at this point. You really should use ivory. I had them mixed up back then. For her lip, I mixed a touch of cadmium red deep with white and painted three layers on her bottom lip. I wanted there to be a contrast between the top lip and the bottom lip. I wanted to make the top lip more brownish. So I mixed burnt umber into my darkest red color and then glazed that over her top lip. And then I mixed more red into my light pink color and glazed that in layers over her bottom lip. I want to insert here that if I was doing this painting now, I would use either quinacridone red or transparent middle red from the Amsterdam line. If you've been watching my channel for a long time, this painting might be familiar to you because I did upload a video about it, I think a little over a year ago, but it was super short, super fast. I wanted to make one that was a bit slower where I could go into more detail and give you more tips and hopefully it'll just be easier to follow. So when I say I use a particular shade or color for this painting, but now I would do things differently, it's because I've learned more since I made this. Ironically, when I was doing this, I had just started to become acquainted with different sizes of round brushes instead of just the small one that I use all the time. Now I don't use a very large variety of round brushes, I just have this one small round brush that I use pretty much all the time, and there's no real reason for that. It's not that round brushes are bad, I guess I just prefer my filberts most of the time. And I just use the one round brush when I need something smaller than what a filbert can give me, and then my liner when I need something even smaller than that. For the ornament on her forehead, I mixed deoxyzine purple, you can use any dark purple really, into Van Dyke brown, but again, you can use any dark brown, and apply this all over the ornament. I mixed zinc white into this color and applied it in the center. Now, I want to talk about this thing for a minute. When I was looking at the photo, before I even started painting, I just thought, that's a brown dot. But by the time I got to painting this, I'd been looking at this photo for a long time. And when you look at something over a period of time, you start to see things, especially you start to see colors that you wouldn't see if you just looked at it for a second, like the way most people look at photos. And I saw there was purple in that. So I mixed purple into the brown instead of just using straight brown like I thought I would. I painted her hair using varying shades of gray made by mixing Mars Black, again should have been Ivory Black, and Zinc White, going from a medium charcoal shade to an almost black shade. I mixed a much lighter gray color and using two different size liner brushes, painted streaks of this color making them more curved going towards her face. I put touches of Zinc White into these clumps. This gave her hair texture and depth. I follow the same technique to paint her brows. I'm sorry, that should have been two different size round brushes, but just reiterating, it was the use of a wide variety of shades going from the light gray to the dark charcoal that gave the hair its texture and gave it depth, like I said. I went over her jewelry, which was already shades of gray, with a transparent gray that I made by mixing transparent mixing white or zinc white and ivory black. Looking back now, if I was doing this painting over, I don't know if I would have done that. After all, they were already the right colors anyway. But at the time, I thought every part of my underpainting needed to have other paint over it. Sometimes you change your mind as an artist. By the way, painting all those little details in the jewelry was a pain, but it was well worth it. Just thinking about this, I'm reminded that it's really amazing how much we can accomplish as artists if we're just willing to slow down and just take some time. I have an old video about needing patience as an artist, and I'm going to include a card for that here, and I'm also going to include a card for my video. So it's something like, draw a bit faster by slowing down or something like that. And I'm just adding some finishing touches right now with my small round brush again. I believe this is some kind of necklace I'm painting here. You see, at one point I'm holding the canvas in my hand because it was easier to get to the bottom of the canvas that way. And because I'm working in acrylics and the edges were already dry, it gave me the freedom to do that. Here I'm just painting a shadow around her face, which is just a darker version of my background color, so she stands out from the background more and looks more three-dimensional. Even if you have something against a solid color background, this is just a really good trick. And you can see that I'm following the shape of her head with the shadow that I'm making. And here it is, the finished piece. Here's another video you might like. This is of me painting my neighbor's dog, Cody, in acrylics.
I make videos with art demos and tips every week, so if that sounds good to you, please subscribe and let me help you bring out your creativity.